meet a girl like you again. Out of everything I lost a friend. Trying to get over you and try to convince myself every night.
Hey, and welcome back to the Blue Room with the Blue Lights, where we speak facts. Yes, today we're going to talk about success. Wonderful success. So I'm going to look up on my phone here on Google what success means. Success, the accomplishment of an aim or purpose. So, purpose. Success, and this is what a lot of people got to understand. Success is not measured on about how much you make. It's about how much you've done. Okay? Success is not measured by how much you make. It's measured on how much you've done. Which then aims for accomplishments. It's aim for accomplishments or purpose. Accomplishments is about how much you have done. Accomplishments is what you do. Like, for instance, I told myself, I said, hey self, I'm going to get my driver's license no later than my birthday. Last year, of course, which I did. And I got it the day after Thanksgiving. My birthday is in February. I did it before my birthday. I got my permit. Then I said, hey self, I'm going to get a job around that same time. And you know what? I got that job before I got my permit. So now I have a permit and a job. Okay? And now I said, hey self, I'm going to get me a car. Which I am still working on, and it is a work in progress, and we are getting somewhere. But also, another thing you must understand about success is you have to not compare yourself to somebody else's success. Okay? Everybody is built different. They tolerate things different. They learn different. Their dreams are different. And they meet their success where they meet their success. Joe over here may have a Lamborghini, living in a $500,000 house with money longer than Pinocchio's nose. And Bob over here probably is like a billionaire, owning multi-billion millionaire businesses, and like is the CEO of Rich, and got like 5 cars in his driveway, and hang around with Rick Ross and like Drake and like freaking LeBron James. And then Mary works her butt off, 3 jobs, with a nice little townhouse, nice little buggy, you know, to feed her kids and her husband. Everybody grind is the same. There's nothing different that a rich man or middle class person or lower person, there's no difference between their grinds. They just got to different levels at different times, or they may not be there yet. You cannot, and I repeat, you cannot compare your success to somebody else. Because really, if you think about it, if you're surrounded by so many people who are doing things, this person just bought them a new house at the age of 23, where a lot of people down buy houses till at the age of what? After 23? There's kids on YouTube, 19, not too far from my age, 18 even, 17, 6, 15. It's getting younger. They're accomplishing adult categorized things like buying a house, a car, buying, not renting, buying a house, buying a car. And there's nothing with renting. Because if you can rent, you can buy. Simple. But people buying cars and houses at the age of 16, 17, 18, 19. And you're like, well, what in the world do they do for a living to be able to even do that? And then, you know, they just blessed. I see it all the time on YouTube. There's kids 16, 17, 18, get all this money they make off of YouTube, of course. And they buying their mama's new houses, two stories, three stories, buying their mama's cars, Birkin bags, Louis bags, Chanel bags, bundles. Buying her, just giving her money, stacks of money, 10K. Oh, here you go, Ma. Nothing. It's a breeze to me. While I'm here, I'm, you know, still like thinking, like, whoa, hammer. Like, because my goal in life is, of course, to be wealthy. And not your average wealthy. I'm trying to be like Bill Gates wealthy, like Oprah Winfrey wealthy, like any of the black multimillionaire woman. You know? And I'm thinking at 17, I'm like, yeah, I know where I wanna go. But how am I gonna get there? You know, we like moving so fast. It's just like, boy, boy, boy. I just feel like I ain't got nothing figured out. Just really feel like I don't have nothing figured out. Like, I know I have the drive, the motivation, and encouragement. And I can do it. But it's just like, I want so much for myself. But it's just like, I keep thinking, man, how I'm going to get there? How I'm going to get there? What can I do to get there? And I know I can research. I pray a lot already. I can ask other people who are successful. I can, you know, do small things to get to the bigger steps. But it's like, still, man, what can I do now to guarantee my future? And then I also have to think, I gotta take it one by one, day by day. But I just know I'm gonna achieve every goal I'll ever set for myself. Because it's personal. It's personal. I want to do it all. I just want to go so hard for myself that I don't need nothing or no one. I already really don't ask for much. As a kid, I'm still a kid. When I was young, I never really asked for much, really. Because I have enough to not ask. Only time I would want something is when I get asked, hey, what do you want for your birthday? Or, hey, what would you like for Christmas? Other than that, I don't ask anything. If I have my own money, I buy my own stuff. A lot of the stuff I do have, I bought myself. These AirPods in my ear. Bro, this was like $250. I bought that on my own. I'm recording on my iPhone 11. That was $767. I bought that on my own. I bought two pairs of UGG slides. Bought that on my own. I got that on a deal, thank the Lord. Because, baby. And, you know, I just bought a lot of hoodies in my, like, clothes and shoes in my... I got so many slides. I'm a slide person. I wear slides all the time. I got, like, so many pairs of slides that I done bought. I bought a lot of things for myself with my own money that I worked hard for. Which, I have no problem with that. A lot of people, grown people, they say, oh... So you just wait till you're 18. You just wait till you have to pay bills. And I ain't have no problem with that. I have no problem with paying bills. And I know it's going to be hard at times. You're not, you know. I know money's going to get low at times. This world revolves around money. I'm just getting used to it now. Once I get my car, I'll be paying car insurance on it. So, hey, that's a bill. Might as well get used to doing it now. So, when I do become of age, I already know what to do. A lot of people try to use it to, like, scare you or discourage you, no. This is going to make me want to do it. To go harder and do it better, you know. But I'm just saying, it's just to say, success is not how much you can measure it by. It's not the zeros. It's not the nice cars, the nice house, the nice clothes. No, it's about what you've accomplished. What have you done? And have you helped others while doing it? It's one thing to have $1 million and have 1 million people on the street. Hungry, homeless, or 1 million people poor that just need money. You can help them. The point of getting to being successful is to be successful and then help somebody else. That's the point. It's to help others. Once you get there, then you're supposed to help somebody else get there too. When they get there, they can help somebody else. And when they get there, they can help somebody else. That's how it should be. Too many people who rich and keep the rich to themselves. Or it's too many people that's rich and then spend half of the money that they done got on cars that they don't even know how to drive. But it was like, oh, I'm gonna get it just because I'm just rich. It just looks nice. But don't even know how to drive it. That's tough. That's really tough. That's really tough. But just know, man, there is nothing in this God-given world that you cannot do. Nothing. There's several stories of people who came from the slums, the projects. I'm talking about down, the low, the gutter. And they rich now. They, you know, they rich, they successful. Got everything they ever was wishing for, you know? And it don't happen like that overnight. So you gotta put in your work. Gotta put in their work. And then maybe you'll be blessed enough along the way to where you're trying to go. Be blessed with people who want to help you and get you there too. That's rare for somebody to do that. But I always make sure it's for the right intentions. A lot of people try to help you to get you to where you want to be because they see how big you're going to be. And they say, I can make money off of them. Watch out for them type of people. But anyhow, as long as it's genuine, if you know that it's genuine, you feel that it's genuine, then it's okay. Boy, that's what we're going to talk about today in the blue room with the blue lights, so we speak facts. And, don't nobody tell you can't do what you can't do. Chase them dreams. Chase them dreams like you ain't gonna live tomorrow. Every day, do something little, medium, or big to get to where you want to be. This world is your canvas. You must paint it to how you want it to be. I'm Ashley. This is the blue room with the blue lights where we speak facts. And I am out. See you in my next video.